Swift D. I did do my chemotherapy. As I told you in my last video, I did miss my last chemotherapy session. They had to do some blood work and stuff like that for me today. It was a little bit of kind of a weird vibe. It was mostly weird because I honestly did not want to go today, guys. I'm not even going to lie to you. I honestly did not want to go to the doctor today. I definitely was not in the mood. I really was not trying to go today. Like, I don't know why I'm in such a rut. So, lately, I've been really... I don't want to say lately, but this entire week, I want to say from Monday up until today. Today is Friday. Well, technically, it's Saturday morning, but I really wasn't feeling going outside. I didn't want to be around nobody. I just wanted to be around one person. I've been eating, barely eating, because my stomach has been upset. I definitely have been sleeping a lot. My stomach has been acting a little funny again. And I can't really blame it on food now. Because I can't really blame it on food for the simple fact that I haven't been eating. So this week I have been eating healthy. I have been eating fruits. I made me a salad a couple of times. When I did cook meat, like I made stir fried chicken slices, and I couldn't even eat that. It's like I ate a couple pieces and I just got disgusted. Like I didn't even want it. So maybe that's my body telling me that I'm ready to go completely plant-based. I don't know. Maybe I know my taste buds are definitely changing because I don't like certain things that I liked before. Like before, I could drink a lot of juice, a lot of soda. I can't even take that anymore. Water, I could drink water, but I'm more of an ice girl. So I can chew on ice forever. It don't matter the season, the weather, whatever. Just give me the ice. I could drink water, but I prefer to eat ice. My doctor did tell me that I have to be careful of dehydration. I noticed that I do get dehydrated a lot, especially when I wake up in the middle of the night and I'm thirsty. That's why I always keep a cup of water next to my bed for me to drink. What else? Certain foods, I'm just not with it. I don't know what it is. Maybe that's me stepping into my adult stomach, but I can't. So, physical updates. I'm glad that I have on this off the shoulder top. So as you guys can see, this is part of where I had radiation, so it's still dark. It hasn't lightened up. I did do research on how I can lighten up this area here. Underneath my arm where they did the lymph node surgery and part of my breast that they did the lumpectomy is still kind of dark. So I am going to start treating my skin the natural way to lighten it back up. So I heard if I use, well, I did research. So baking soda, lemon juice from lemons, rub it on my skin daily, it should lighten up the pigmentation. And I started my research on finding a plastic surgeon. I found a few plastic surgeons in my area, in the New York City area, that does do the breast reconstruction and the nipple reconstruction and fat transfer to the breast. Because I don't think I want to do silicone. I think I want to use my own fat, but there are risks to that if you use your own fat, especially if you're coming off of cancer. So they do would have to test the area, but we'll see how that goes. What else? can I talk about? Oh yeah, exercise. Now, I have been doing yoga, 10 minutes of yoga in the bed every morning when I wake up to do, just to give me a couple minutes of exercise throughout the day. So, it's going pretty well. I know I have to find another form of exercise. So, I am going to look into different things that I can do with my injury. So, I know it's kind of cold and I don't have access to a pool, but hopefully in the summertime or when it gets warmer, I can find a gym that has a pool, because that'll be easier on my body for me to work out. So that's all for my update for today, guys. Thank you again for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and I see you in my next one. Bye. Wait.